Welcome everyone. I am Bapu Gada, quality reviewer from Division of Lifecycle API. In this presentation, I will discuss about recommended documentation for API sameness for synthetic therapeutic polymers, specifically cross-coupled polymers. For the approval of generic drugs, API sameness is required to show pharmaceutical equivalency. It is considered same APIs orally if it possesses same physical and chemical characteristics as RLD. I will be showing few examples of cross-coupled polymers and discussing about the approach to determine the API sameness of this kind of complex molecules. This is the title of the poster presentation, Synthetic Therapeutic Polymers Recommended Documentation for API Sameness. In this slide, I am showing three examples for cross-coupled polymers. In cross-coupled polymers, two or more polymer chains are coupled together with linker portion. Here, the first example, sevelamer, which is derivative of polyalylamine cross-coupled with epichlorohydrin. Colsevelam hydrochloride. There are additional alkylations in addition to the cross-coupling of polyalylamine with epichlorohydrin. There are two types of cross-coupling in pentyromer. Additional pentyromer ion is complex with calcium sorbitol. I just give a little background about these three molecules. All these three examples are FDA approved drugs. Currently, sevelamer and colsevelam have approved generic equivalents. Sevelamer is approved as carbonate salt and hydrochloride salt for treating hyperphosphatemia. Colsevelam hydrochloride is approved as cholesterol lowering agent. Pentyromer is scavenger of potassium and used to lower blood potassium levels. As discussed in previous slides, these molecules have complex chemical structures. These molecules show following properties. Each particle is considered as one molecule and molecular weight is depending on the particle size. So there is no fixed molecular weight for these molecules. However, the molecular formula can be derived. The API contains heterogeneous complex mixtures of small molecules and treated as a single active ingredient. In general, cross-coupled polymers are not soluble in any solvent. These drugs are not absorbed. The activity of these drugs is scavenging. The intended activity happens in gastrointestinal tract. Hence, the characterization using traditional methods to establish API sameness is difficult. Each complex molecule possesses different properties and challenges. Hence, the principles to determine API sameness for each complex API is also different. So, hence, the totality of evidence approach is recommended for API sameness for cross-coupled polymers. In this strategy, the information of manufacturing process such as selection starting materials, control of intermediates, characterization of intermediates is used to establish API sameness. The orthogonal methods are used to confirm the structural signatures of the final API. Usually, it is done on multiple lots to show consistency from batch to batch. The impurity profile should be assessed and justified the limits in API as well as in chemicals used in the process, such as starting materials and intermediates. In vitro biological activity is considered to establish APS sameness. Where required, provide the justification for analytical methods used for the characterization of APIs and intermediates. To establish the equivalence, it's recommended to use at least 3 batches of data with at least 3 batches of RLD. So, as I discussed, manufacturing process of also one of the parameter in the API sameness, I discuss about few principles to consider in manufacturing process. The equivalent starting material expected to provide equivalent structural signatures of the molecule. The applicant process should contain same chemicals proposed in the product label for sevelamer and colsevelam. If other materials are used, justification should be provided. Once crop scrubbing is done, the material is not soluble in any of the solvents. Hence, unwanted structural fragments cannot be identified after cross-coupling if they present. Proper controls for impurities should be established for the starting materials, intermediates, and reagents used in the process so that unnecessary reactions won't happen. For suppose, if polyalanine presents some reactive amine groups which addition to polyalanine, they may react with epichlorohydrin and can give some impurities which cannot be identified. The amount of cross-coupling reagent used in the reaction can have effect on the degree of cross-coupling. Similarly, the amount of alkylating agents in proposed reaction conditions can affect the percentage alkylations. In some manufacturing conditions, like CPP, should be established with appropriate amount of cross-coupling reagent and alkylating agents to get the proposed structure. Demonstrate the analytical methods are suitable to use for IPC and CPP and other analysis of KSM and intermediates. Establish adequate release and stability specifications, including impurity profile for API based on the data obtained for API extracted from RLD. Batch data on at least 3 batches is required to show consistent process. Manufacturing process should be in compliance with cGMP regulations. So the characterization can be discussed as characterization of intermediates and characterization of final API. In the preparation of colsevelam, there are at least 2 intermediates, polyalanine and cross-coupled polyalanine. Polyalanine is the backbone for sevelamer and colsevelam. On the final API, the properties of polyalanine cannot be determined. Hence, appropriate controls for polyalanine, such as molecular weight, should be established at intermediate stage on polyalanine. Due to complexity of NMR, the degree of cross-coupling is difficult to establish on final API. It is recommended to evaluate the degree of cross-coupling on cross-coupled polyalanine intermediate using solid-state NMR and other analytical methods. The cross-coupled polyalanine is the final API in sevelamer. The degree of cross-coupling in sevelamer and colsevelam are different. Additionally, other characterization methods such as IR, elemental analysis, TGA, DSC should be compared for batch-to-batch consistency of the intermediates. And these tests also can be used to compare degree of cross-coupling. It's recommended to use at least 3 batches of data to show consistency of intermediates from batch to batch. In addition to the optimized process parameters and quality of intermediates, orthogonal methods are recommended to compare structural signatures of API with API in RLD. The methods recommended are generally IR, elemental analysis, solid state NMR, TGA, DSC, total titratable amines, swell index, and others. And these tests also provide the information on degree of cross-coupling and degree of alkylation. Hence, these tests can be used during the process development also. Other physicochemical properties such as physical form, particle size distribution, bulk density, tap density, swelling ratio, surface morphology, compressibility, and others should be also compared. Compare in vitro bile acid binding study for colsevalamer, phosphate binding study for sevalamer, potassium binding study for pyridinamer to show these molecules have similar scavenging property as RLD. Compare data from at least 3 batches of API and 3 batches of API in RLD to show the consistency and equivalency. As discussed, to establish the API sameness for cross-coupled polymers, totality of evidence approach should be used. Development studies are needed to establish the quality of basic polymeric chain, amount of cross-coupling reagent, and amount of alkylating agents and reaction conditions. The API should be compared with API obtained from RLD to proposed API is highly similar to RLD. Compare in vitro biological activity to support the proposed API's similar scavenging properties as RLD. Provide necessary literature support where needed. These are the references if you would like to refer. The product-specific guidances from FDA are available for sevalamer and colsevalamer. Thank you for your time, and if you have any questions or comments, please send them to email address on the slide. Looking forward to seeing you at the workshop in March.